Hello, welcome to Madeblo series. This week I made a parallax effect for the background of the game. I will probably change the perspective of the image, as it doesn't match the game's view. But the system is in place. I also made a tile for the stone of the mountain. If you enjoy the progress of the game, please subscribe and leave a like. And if you have suggestions for the channel or the game, leave a comment below. At the start of the week, I decided to get rid of the placeholder background of the prototype, and also add a nice parallax effect to give it a sensation of depth. For this, I will need several images. Each of these images will be an independent layer on a sprite. Although this background will only be shown in specific points of the game, I think it will add immersion to the game. But as I said, I will probably change it as it has a wrong perspective. But maybe I could use this for a side view section of the game. Something like a short walk with a narrative meaning. We will see about that. The first of the images is the sky and clouds. This image will not have a parallax effect, as it will move with the camera. The rest of the images will be independent for the camera, at least at some degree. They will move with the camera, but in a different amount to simulate depth. For this I needed to create a new script. This script will have a reference of the camera and a parallax multiplier. This variable is a number that will be multiplied by the movement of the camera. For example, if the multiplier is 2, the image will move twice as much as the camera. I also added code to handle the tiling of the image. This is for creating an infinite image, no matter where the camera is moving to. Then I added the script to the images and gave it a test. The parallax effect was working, but something was wrong with the tiling of the images. I needed to modify the code a bit to handle resized images. Now the images were tiled correctly. No matter how I move the player, the background will always show a tiled image. By the way, this parallax was inspired by CodeMonkey's video. I will leave a link in the description. The effect was working great, but I wanted to try something. Maybe if I added some blur to the images, the depth would be better. Once again, I asked the community about this blur effect. Almost everyone hated it. Some people asked for the effect to be optional, with the possibility of turning it on or off in the settings of the game. But a lot of people pointed out that this effect broke the art style of the game. So I decided to go without blur. I modified the colors a bit so they are not so saturated, and changed the position of the images a bit for a better effect. Here was the result. When some people saw the video where I was asking about the blur effect of the parallax, they pointed out that the edges of the world were horrible. I explained to them that the tileset are temporary, but I decided to spend some time making a tileset for these edges. For this I'm using Unity's tile system, but with an additional package for rule tiles and other functionalities. A rule tile is a tile that changes depending on whatever it has on the sides. This makes creating sceneries much faster and easier. When I made the prototype, I created a path rule tile to test things out. I will use this path tile as a template for creating a new rock tile. After I set up the new rule tile, I started placing the tiles on the prototype level. As you see, the tile changes depending on the other tiles around it. The idea is to cover every edge with this tile and try to make it look a bit organic. In fact, I think some of the areas of the mountain should almost be all rock, especially the top of the mountain. But as I say, the tilesets are temporary, and the prototype level will not be in the final game. And that was my week. I decided to make this video shorter and to the point. Do you like this format? It will let me focus more on the game and less on the videos. And I think these kind of videos are more enjoyable. Anyway, I hope you like my content and, as I said, let me know if you have any suggestions for the game or the channel. You can follow me on Twitter or join the Discord server for more frequent updates. Thanks for watching. See you next week.